So 2034 imagines what it would look like if the US and China went to war in that aforementioned year, and it's told from the perspective of five main characters, include a American female admiral, an American fighter pilot, a Chinese admiral, an Iranian officer, and an Indian American who works at the White House. My military experience gave me an understanding really of that world and some of the technical aspects of that world, but it also gave me an understanding of my characters and what it's like to go to war and experience it from an emotional perspective as well. So this novel was, for me, the first collaboration I had ever done, and I did it with Admiral James Stavridis, who's the former Allied commander of NATO, but it's also a very read, well-read, with fiction and other types of stories. And so our collaboration really worked well because we both had the same vision for the book, which was a book that would be character-driven, but also a real page-turner. So it was a pleasure to work with him on this. So lots of the Admiral's military experience is in there as well. The geopolitics, the technical aspects in terms of how the Navy works. And so we took both of our experiences and kind of folded them together to kind of create the world that is 2034. Well, I think that oftentimes, you know, fiction and stories are a reflection of the world in which we live. And so sometimes we start to see those stories manifesting in actual events as opposed to fictitious events. And the whole reason we wrote 2034 is it's not a work of predictive fiction, it's a work of cautionary fiction, because sometimes the way we avoid the worst outcomes in our world is by imagining them, and by imagining them we make sure they never happen. Yes, so I have a new work of nonfiction that will come out in the United States in the fall. It's about the end of the war in Afghanistan. And then I have a new novel that will come out next year in the United States that's about the American Civil War and the controversy around the removal of Civil War monuments in the US. But we're also turning 2034, we've signed on to turn it into a trilogy. So there will be a 2054 and a 2074 that take these characters out into the future. I don't find it frightening, but I think, again, I think one of the best things we can do to avoid worst outcomes is to fully imagine them, recognize them, and then begin to do the work we need to make sure that they don't become realities. So that's what keeps me from being frightened that 2034 is going to turn into a true life as opposed to a book of fiction.